with music from Steve Hackett. The song is called Every Day, and the man had made that music almost got here last year, just around this time, but circumstances weren't to be. But he's here tonight, and he's at the Triangle Theater. Steve Hackett, welcome to Rochester again.
Hi there, how are you?
And you've been here at least, let me see, one, two, three, maybe three times, maybe four.
Yeah.
And people will and do respond very well to your music, and it's a pleasure to have you up here this afternoon for an interview, and even nicer to have you in town to make some music.
Sure, it's good to be back.
Now, last year we just mentioned that you almost made it, and there was, I guess, an American tour scheduled, and things didn't happen.
Right.
Where have you been between then and now? Because it was almost went into oblivion as far as any public appearances in the States go.
Right. Well, I went through a change of record company and well, various things. We were touring consistently in England and Europe, then getting the new album together. I mean, there's been a lot of things, although it looks like there hasn't been activities, a lot of things that have been going on backstage for me, if you like, you know. And there's certain things that you have to do, and reorganization, and
let's talk a little bit about the band. Now, the band has been consistent for the last two albums for the most part. Everyone has been the same. Where did you find these players? Because they're like all these sleeping giants that all of a sudden appear on your album, and everyone works so well together, and they're all excellent musicians.
Well, the band was put together, combination of friends and recommendations. There's my brother who people will probably remember from Days of Voyage of the Acolyte and Please Don't Touch. So we were working together for a long time before we were able to do something on a regular basis. Then there's a guy, Nick Magnus, who's my keyboard player. In fact, I found him out of a sort of ad out of the back pages of an English trade paper called Melody Maker. And everyone just works really well together. That's the main thing. It's pretty much like a family.
Now, there is a distinctive sound that you carry with your guitar work, which has been distinctive ever since you've made, I guess, a great amount of a success in the public. I can't ask you how you make that, because it would be a hard question to explain. But how do you maintain your style of music and still be diversified into different songs? Because as soon as you hear a piece of music that you create or write or perform, it's instantly recognizable as your guitar style.
Well, that's nice to know, but at the same time, as you say, I mean, there's various things I'm interested in. Some of the things from Defector are extremely diverse. You know, you might have something like an acoustic guitar passage followed by maybe something that sounds more American with harmonies, and then you might have the instrumentals, which are probably the most distinctively British sounding, maybe. You know, that kind of experimental type of approach. Normally sort of a combination of keyboards and guitar woven together, so that you can't necessarily tell the difference between the instruments. It's a case of blurring the edges, and of course working with things like flute, which is again something slightly different and puts it in the realms of the more classical maybe and orchestral sounding things.
When you sit down and construct an album, do you try to get to everything that you, some classical, some rock, something that will appeal to American audience, something that will appeal to a British audience, or is it something that you just feel that you want to put together for that album?
Well, normally it's a case of all the ideas that I've gotten at any one particular time. On Defector again, we have something like, there's a sort of Glenn Miller pastiche track, you know, something that sounds like it could have been made in the 1930s, unless you listen that closely to the lyric and you realize that it's it isn't that serious, but it's trying to combine all the worst points of the crooner type approach when it comes down to singing. I mean, there's so many things that I'm into, and I think all the albums so far have been like that. You know, every idea at a tangent to every other one. So there hasn't really been any one central thing, but it's possible in the future I may start making albums which are consistently into one direction more, from the point of view of just a personal discipline in that in that sense, so that people can say, ah, yes, and perhaps one could be able to encapsulate it all in one word and say, this is an instrumental album, for instance, or this is an album of songs, or an album of acoustic guitar pieces.
Right. What about, you talked a little bit about singing, what about the vocalist? Because he, like everyone else in the band, is extremely distinct and extremely individual in his own presentation. Where is his roots there, or does he have any background that we would recognize as far as singing with anyone else?
No, Pete's a newcomer, and he's quite a find as far as I'm concerned, because he manages to do a number of styles. I don't think he sounds the same from one track to the next. As I said, there's the Glenn Miller thing where he's doing the crooner bit, and then there's something like the show where it's an out front vocal. There's lots of different styles really that I think if you get a good enough singer, you know, you'd be amazed how many different styles a guy can cover.
And this American tour, things are smaller than, let's say, what you've used to been touring into 10,000, 15,000, and 17,000 seat venues from before.
Mm-hmm.
You haven't had any trouble adjusting, and we talked a little bit before we came on the air, and it gives you a chance to become a little more intimate and closer with the audience. You like that?
Oh, sure. I mean, the nice thing about the two gigs that I've just done, for instance, is that afterwards I can meet everybody and go and have a drink at the bar or something like that.
And they'll take advantage of that tonight, that's for sure. They'll do that.
And I think the other thing is that when you're on stage as well, you know, you can kind of communicate in a way that isn't entirely musical, perhaps, but you can almost hold conversations with people with facial expressions, I think, and that's something you just cannot do in a larger place.
I have one more question, and it's been asked me to ask you this. Do you do any old material? And we'll leave the question at that.
From the old days? Well, there's something that I do. I play some acoustic guitar at one point during the act, and there's some references for people if they picked up on things in the past. Certainly.
Great. You're at the Triangle Theater, and I want to thank you. I can't wait to... We tried real hard to get you here last year, and it almost worked, and this year it worked, and it's in a great place. And you're down there. It's just an evening with Steve Hackett. There is no opening.
That's right. There isn't a support.
That's even better. And you get right into it right away.
That's right.
Thanks for coming up, and thanks for making the music tonight in town and on the Defector album. We'll hear some music from that right now. Thanks again.
Thanks.